This is Handmade Home. I am Hester, and today I have a very easy woodwork project for you. When I moved my little girl Kiki, who is 2 in January, into her bigger room, all the walls were quite plain. They since redecorated, there's some wallpaper, there's some art, but one wall above the painted radiator I did, if you missed that by the way, head over to my blog. I've done this really lovely painted radiator tutorial. Not a video, but yeah, on the blog. Sidetrack there. This wall has the painted radiator, but I wanted something else on there, something a little bit of a focal point. So I thought, why not make a shelf, not so much to store lots of things, but more decorative. So I had a look at the timber I had left over, and I had quite a bit of pellet wood and a really nice plank of pine. So have a look and see what I came up with. I'm using pellet wood that's 7 centimeters wide. And I'll put the dimensions of what you need to cut in the description box below, but you can make any kind of size houses. And you're gonna have straight cuts at the bottom, but the top cut and the roof are gonna be angled at 30 degrees. That's why a miter saw is very handy, like this one I'm using here. So for a house, you're gonna have 2 sides, with a straight end and a 30 degree top. And you're gonna have 2 roof pieces that both have a 30 degree angle. I'm gonna put it together like so. Before we can do that, we need to give it a good sand first. So with my palm sander, I'm just gonna smooth the edges, the top. Pellet wood can be quite rough, so give it a good smoothing down. And then we're gonna glue our house together. I like using the Gorilla Wood glue and apply that to the cuts you made. And press your house together. And to keep it in place, you're gonna wrap tape around it. Just the wood glue will do, just has to set for 24 hours. But if you want to work a little bit faster, you don't want to wait that long, you can put a little nail or 2 nails in every joint, just like so. In my timber stash, I found this really lovely plank that I used before, as you can see by these little screw holes, that is 64 centimeters long and 36 centimeters deep. I'm going to use this as the base of the plank, give it a good sand. And then it's time for some paint. I'm using the Rust-Oleum All Surface Paint, and this one is the matte white. Give it a good stir and then apply it to your plank. It's kind of like a lacquery paint, so you only need 1 coat. The houses are gonna get painted well, but I'm only gonna paint the inside. And I'm using the colors Rose, Lagoon and Satin Black, which are the same colors I also use on the painted radiator. You can tape your house off if you want a really neat line, but I'm just gonna eyeball it with a small brush. I'm gonna give the 3 houses a nice coat of paint. Once the paint is dry, with a little bit of sandpaper, you can just smooth down the edges, just in case you made any little smudges. Just arranging the houses in a way that I think looks quite nice. I'm gonna put wood glue on the side of the houses and clamp them together, just to give them a bit of stability once they're on the shelf. I'm gonna let this dry for a day. I'll be back tomorrow. There we have a little village. To make it easy for you to attach this to the plank, just on the bottom of the plank, so the wrong side, I'm gonna line the houses up and I'm gonna make little marks of where they're gonna sit. Then these marks you can use as a guideline to know where to drill your pilot holes. You can see the marks are here. I'm just gonna drill 2 holes in between the marks. We're gonna use these to screw in the houses from underneath. Like so. And now we just need to make some brackets. What you're gonna do is you're gonna take the depth of your plank, which is the top piece of wood here. You have that minus the thickness of the wood, which is the back. And then you're gonna measure what the diagonal piece is gonna be. And this you're gonna cut at a 45 degree angle, like this. Then you're gonna glue it all together, nail it together, and that's your bracket done. Couldn't be any easier. The bracket got a coat of white paint too. I'm using a furniture paint here though. It doesn't cover as nicely. But I drilled the bracket into the wall using wall plugs. And now all I have to do is put the shelf on top and screw this in place. And give the bracket and the side of the shelf another coat of paint, because this definitely won't do. But there you have it. My shelf with little houses is all done. pleased with the outcome of the shelf. It looks really cute. I think it's nice. I've stored a few little trinkets on there. Just have them ready for when Kiki wakes up and she can play with the little toys and her books. And as you can see, it's very easy to make your own brackets. Of course, you don't have to do this. There's a lot of nice DIY shops that sell ready-made brackets. But while you're making the shelf, might as well make your own brackets. And then for sure know they're the right size. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up and have a look at all the other videos here on the Handmade Home channel. I'll be back soon with a new video and I really hope to see you then.